What's up, guys? This is Jimmy, also known as Jumanji1776. I'm a moderator, founder, owner, and activist of optiongoatsllc. That's right. We are based out of the state of Wisconsin. Registered LLC. We are not financial advisors nor licensed. If you need financial help, please consider looking for a financial advisor. This is your swing weekly recap for November 15th through November 19th. There were some good trades, some bad trades, a couple things that we added, some stayed stagnant, but all in all, we ended up very green and we opened up a very interesting play that I'm really excited to go over. But first things first, make sure you like and subscribe at the bottom right of the video. Check out our other videos that we have. You're like, Jim, I have no idea what Discord is. I don't know what options are. I don't know what you are. I don't know how go to Devin's Fred Crash Course Option Goats page. Check out OG Prime 2. Excuse me, do not check out OG Prime 2.
I'm going to make a new one of those. 50 and 200 SMA trading on the SPY. And then if you want to know how I trade, go to Devin's Fred Crash Course. That's
exactly how I trade. Time I trade. Minus with over some. But I'll go over that here in a minute. Make sure to check out our website. If you go to our website, optiongoatsllc.com, and you go down here, it's free membership. You can find free resources to our Discord.
But if you go for the Prime membership, which is $60 per month, you would be able to get the trade ideas that I have, share the option flow, and then you also get access to the bot that's our provider through Traded.
So if you use the code SPRING30, that will be sent off for 3 months. For 30 each, so you save about 36.
So keep that in mind, use the code SPRING30. All right, let's go over some profits that we had last week. Let's see,
profits.
Let's start, and it was the 15th. Here we go. Nas killing it. Green 55 for the day. We closed profits on TTCF. That was a beautiful play, couldn't be happier. Here's another one. Looks like from Martil on, this looks like Microsoft. Yeah, Microsoft and SPY. Nice job there. 10% gain right there. 50% gain right there. That is sweet. Nas El Banker.
Again, 115 day right there.
We ate on Apple this day, and then we also ate more throughout the day. I'll go over that for you. Martil, make it 32% on the Apple call. Nice job. Apple was friggin' awesome. Here is one of my buddy's portfolios that he helps, that I help him with. Yeah, Apple calls, here we go, that were 280%. He bought six of them. That was a good call. Here's our TTCF play that we ended up getting out for 81% profit.
Nazel Banker.
$120 at the end of the day. Nice job, man. That is so weird. All right, so let's go over some of the plays we had. So the cheap lead that we grabbed, or actually, did we close TTCF? Yes, okay. So let's pull up our charts here. TTCF ended up being a very good play. I'm starting to do this thing where I'm just looking for stocks that have really high IV and then selling juice on it, whether that be puts, whether it be calls, whatever it may be, as far out the money as I can. And then just letting theta and IV do its thing. So let's take a look at TTCF. So here was the dip. TTCF just had, this is a weekly, oops, here we go. So it came down here like this, and then it came down even lower on this day, popped the next day, and then alleviated. So what was the play? We sold a put vertical spread. We sold the 14.5 put, bought the 14 put, expiration was 12.3. We collected $75. The max loss was 175. 4 days later, we were able to capture 82% of that trade. So out of the $75, we basically captured back $55. So that was a really good trade. That ended up being, we were only needed to be into the trade until the 18th, which was Thursday. So we got out of the trade. It was basically a full 6 calendar days, and we made 80% on the trade. I could have gone deeper on the trade, but to stay on the safe side, this is how far the spread was. Look how far down it was. Yeah, we sold premium. We got out profitable on that trade. So really happy with that one. All right, so that was TTCF. So I'm 3 for 3 on selling premium. So first it was, then it was Novavax. Now it was TTCF. So super happy with that play. The next one we have here was our Apple call. This was a cheaply. So I got out maybe a little too early, but this is where our 55 call was. So it was at $14. Okay, and then here's our Apple call. So it went, here it is. So plus 102%, plus 200, plus 253, plus 432, plus 480, and then plus 535. It was ending up being plus $77, and all we had to pay was $14. We paid $14 for the play. Had we held it, how far in the money it went, it actually ended up being $475 at the end of the day on Friday. And I didn't stick to my plan. I should have just kept my call like I usually do for my cheap leads. But, you know, I saw how much money it was making. I was happy with the profits. I'm still happy with the profits. We turned $14 into $75, and it was over a 300% gainer. So I'm really happy with that trade. I know the members were happy with that trade. I wouldn't say I'm the best at picking cheap leads because we had the XOM call the night before, and that didn't do that well. That was like $30 wasted. Yeah, $60. So super happy with that play. All right. So here is a moment you all been waiting for. And then also on Friday, just a heads up, we bought another $100 of SHIB. It is going down right now. And we bought $500. Now we have $500 of SHIB. It's worth $1,160. And it's continuing lower. I wouldn't be surprised if we go back into these levels, consolidates, and then next leg up with, you know, a year or two, who knows. The whole point of this is just to keep collecting cheap with $100. So now we're up to about, I think, 23.5 million sheep. So that was sheep. All right. So this is kind of crazy. I was looking at for premium on this day and I was striking out with what I was finding. Literally, I was looking at LPI, not enough. Liquidity, not enough juice on Fate, SDGR, not enough open strikes, prog was too low, office juiced, but not next expiration is 12-17, too far out for me for how much it was. AMT, oh, don't do this to me, don't, please don't, please. Oh my gosh. Okay. Sorry. I thought my computer crashed for a second. Okay. Anyways, so AMTX, my mouse just died. I was like, no way. Anyways. Okay. So there's that. Okay. Yeah, we're still good. Okay. So Mara is nicely juiced. The 46.45 puts pens are going to a UMWC was too low. I was striking out. Anyways, I was looking at Saba. Saba wasn't filling on the strikes that I wasn't, but I was looking at instead we found Chris. And this stock IV went absolutely ballistic. This is how crazy the premium was on this trade right here. On this trade right here, 40-45 put spread, okay, for 12-17. Let's think about this for a second. The stock is at 52, okay? That's $5, $6, $7.5 away from the money. We were able to sell a put spread. Get this, sell the 45, buy the 40. 12-17 expiration, $290 premium for out the money put spread on right here. The max loss was 210. That's better than 50-50 reward, and we're $7 away. The reason why these puts are pumped so much is because this stock is in a downtrend right now. And what we're going to do is we're going to capture on it for the next 2 to 3 weeks. We're going to make sure that this stock is going to stay above the 45. The Eagles are starting, by the way. So if I get a little off track here in a bit, I'm almost done with the video anyways, so it's out the money, $290 premium. I couldn't believe what I was seeing. Popped up on the IV chart, like, instantly, which was absolutely nuts. So I absolutely, $210 to make 290, and it's $7 away from the spread. All we have to do is just sit and wait, make sure it's above 45. Yeah, this is a great trade, and I feel really good about it. The worst thing that can happen is that it continues on its downtrend violently, and then we would be losing on the trade almost instantly. So that one I'll be watching. As for, anyways, this is what I said. The puts are super pumped on this from the strong downtrend. It seems like the stock takes this time going down and goes back up. Plan is to hold this for a couple of weeks. This is above that 45 line. Buy back cheap. We also have a health aid on this one. And not to mention, we also have Thanksgiving off. That's going to propel data. And then Friday is a half day. Then we're home 2 extra days. The plan is to hold it more than just next week after as well. We should be $90 premium collection on this premium profit on this place. So next week is the last week of November. So keep in mind, members, if you post your profits and your plays, we'll pick one at the end of the month. You'll be an OG Prime Hall of Famer. You'll receive either $50 cash, or we also have OG Prime t-shirts that we have now, Option Goats Trading t-shirts. So hit us up with those. Other than that, guys, make sure to like and subscribe on the video right here on YouTube. Check out our other videos. Check out the other weeks that we had before. Last week was really good. You know what? Last week we capitalized on Apple. We capitalized on TTCF. We bought a little bit more sheep. We opened up a really, really high probability of profitable trade on Chris. I'm feeling really good. I'm going to be gone for 10 days. I'll be very limited on the chat. But I will be back right away, and then we'll be able to get back to cracking on things. So I'll still do the video when I get back. I'm not going to be crazy about doing trades. I am going to still do my cheap on Monday, and I'm still going to sell for me on Friday. So look out for those. Remember, if you like and subscribe and sign up for the OG Prime News. This is your sweet recap for the week of November 15th. Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a great day. Have a great weekend. Have a great trade. Good luck to all, and make sure to stay safe out there, guys. Have a good one.
Bye.